Now to the discovery of a local 2-year-old's body. Police say the child's mother admitted to stuffing the girl in a suitcase and burying her.
It is a crime that has neighbors reeling. 32-year-old Rachel Fryer facing a judge today in Sanford just hours after her young daughter was found buried in Crescent City.
WESH 2 has team coverage of this developing story. Only our cameras were there as the child's father went to meet with police. We begin with WESH 2's Dave McDaniel. And Dave, the mother went before a judge this afternoon.
She did have a court appearance this afternoon. Right now, Sanford investigators are waiting to hear from the medical examiner to hear exactly how this 2-year-old died, but it was a conversation with that 2-year-old's mother that sent them to Putnam County looking for her. Now that mother is here at the Seminole County Jail, being held on just under $1 million bond. It was clear from Chopper 2 early in the morning that investigators appeared to be searching for a body. They went to this remote spot in Putnam County after talking to the mother of 2-year-old Taragi Gordon.
At that location, officers found a shallow grave with a small child's shoe exposed. The shoe was consistent with that of the footwear belonging to Fryer's 2-year-old daughter.
Cops started looking for Taragi early Monday after a case manager working with the family reported a problem.
Heartbroken, saddened, hurt by the turn of events with this family and this young girl.
Rachel Fryer turned herself into police and now is in jail for neglect. In her arrest affidavit, she tells investigators her 2-year-old was unresponsive Thursday morning, that her efforts to get little Taragi breathing failed. She claims she attempted to revive the child by utilizing CPR, and that she attempted to revive the child for 30 minutes before giving up. That's when the affidavit says she dressed the girl, placed her in a suitcase, and asked a friend to drive her to Putnam County, where she has ties. She told cops she dug a grave and placed the body of the child in that grave. Cops say they looked where she said they'd find her daughter. Now, this family had been separated by the state because of some previous issues and was just reunited in November. That's exactly why case managers were checking on them regularly. In fact, a case manager was just there last Thursday and reported that everything was okay. It was that day that the mother tells the Sanford Police Department that she found her daughter unresponsive and that she died later that morning. And that's when all of this started to unravel. The cops accuse her of failing to call 911, just part of the case that they're working to build. Reporting live in Seminole County, Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.